Hey there, this is, we're welcome back to Return to Yehovah. Had something I wanted to share that, just been on my mind for a while recently. A couple of passages of scripture, one from the Tanakh and one from the New Testament. And, I just want to read them to you, and I think you'll find that they sound similar. And I think they're really cool passages, so, let's see what you think. First, I want to start with Isaiah 63, 1 through 6. Now, I'm going to try to just read through it and then pause, okay? So, Isaiah 63, verse 1. Who is this who comes from Edom with dyed garments from Bozra? This one who is glorious in his apparel, traveling in the greatness of his strength. I who speak in righteousness, mighty to save. Just try to picture somebody being this one and saying these things. To me, it sounds kind of cool, you know. And there's a question asked him, why is your apparel red and your garments like one who treads in the winepress? I have trodden the winepress alone, he says. And from the peoples, no one was with me. For I have trodden them in my anger and trampled them in my fury. Their blood is sprinkled upon my garments, and I have stained all my robes. So he's not stained from wine or grape juice. He's stained from blood. And it says, for the day of vengeance is in my heart, and the year of my redeemed has come. Now I want to look at that last part. The year of my redeemed has come. That sounds to me like the time of vengeance or revenge for his redeemed people has finally come. Verse 5 says, I looked, but there was no one to help, and I wondered that there was no one to uphold. Therefore, my own arm brought salvation for me, and my own fury it sustained me. I have trodden down the peoples in my anger, made them drunk in my fury, and brought down their strength to the earth. That's the end of that passage. Now, we could speculate on who that is, or we could see if there's any connection to somewhere else in the Word. The other place I want to go to, which I think is really cool, is Revelation chapter 19. Now, starting in verse 11, going through 16. Now, John is talking about what he's seeing up in heaven or in this vision he had. He says, now I saw heaven opened, and behold, a white horse. And he who sat on him was called Faithful and True. And in righteousness he judges and makes war. Think of what I'm going to read here and, you know, kind of think back to this passage in Isaiah. His eyes were like a flame of fire, and on his head were many crowns. He had a name written that no one knew except himself. He was clothed, get this, he was clothed with a robe dipped in blood, and his name is called the Word of God. And the armies in heaven, clothed in fine linen, white and clean, followed him on white horses. So you've got a whole army coming. Now out of his mouth goes a sharp sword that with it he should strike the nations. And he himself will rule them with a rod of iron. He himself treads the winepress, there's that phrase, of the fierceness and wrath of Almighty God. And he has on his robe and on his thigh a name written, King of Kings and Lord of Lords. Now, I'm guessing that most of you are pretty sure who we're talking about here, but these are, I believe, both pictures of Yeshua, the Messiah, coming to avenge his people. Both talk about him treading the winepress of the wrath of God, or, you know, treading the winepress, and in his fury and anger, he's trampling people. Okay? And, you know, you got to wonder, who are these people or what's going on? So then there's a little bit more that goes on in Revelation 19. And I just think these are cool verses. And if you've never heard this stuff before, check it out, because this is in the Bible and it's very, very descriptive. But yet, if you're on God's side, this is like stuff to make you cheer, you know, because no matter how bad things get and the enemy, you know, attacks God's people or whatever, God is going to eventually come and avenge his people. Let's look at the rest of that chapter, Revelation 19, starting in verse 17. He goes on to say, "Then I saw an angel standing in the sun, and he cried with a loud voice, saying to all the birds that fly in the midst of heaven, 'Come and gather together for the supper of the great God, that you may eat the flesh of kings, the flesh of captains, the flesh of mighty men, the flesh of horses and of those who sit on them, and the flesh of all people, free and slave, both small and great.'" Now, I think we can believe or pretty much understand these are not God's people we're talking about that are going to be devoured. But then it goes on to say, verse 19, "And I saw the beast," the one we refer to now as the Antichrist or whatever, "and the kings of the earth and their armies gathered together to make war against him who sat on the horse and against his army." Now, I don't know about you, but I mean, they obviously, if they're gathered against him, they must see him in some way. And the way he's described, who in their right mind would go up against this guy who, you know, I think we all know now is Yeshua and his army. But they've been deceived enough by the enemy to try it, you know. It goes on, verse 20. So they gathered together to make war against him who sat on the horse and against his army. "Then the beast," this Antichrist character, "was captured, and with him the false prophet, who worked signs in his presence, and by which he deceived those who received the mark of the beast and those who worshipped his image. These two were cast alive into the lake of fire burning with brimstone." And it goes on to say, "And the rest of the people in these armies were killed with the sword which proceeded from the mouth of him who sat on the horse, and all the birds were filled with their flesh." Now, you might wonder, why am I doing this? Why bother reading this? But, you know, this is March of 2019, and there's a lot of people, secular and religious and everywhere in between, that are sure feeling like something is going to happen in this world. It's going to hit the fan in some way. And a lot of people believe we are in or real close to the end times, the last days, however you want to say it. But that means great tribulation coming to the earth, and, you know, a lot of tough times for God's people and all the people of the earth. But, you know, I read briefly there was this beast and this false prophet, and those two are going to somehow have the power to deceive a lot of people, and they're going to trick you into taking, if they can, a mark on the back of your right hand or on your forehead, some kind of mark, some kind of thing. I'm not going to speculate. People think it's a chip or whatever. It doesn't really matter. But somehow they're going to use that to show that you worship this beast person, whoever he's going to be. If you do that, then you're going to be on the side that's going against this mighty warrior, Yeshua, that's coming back. and that was described in these verses. So I'm just saying that as one who believes in Yeshua, that if you are out there and you don't, this is in the Bible. This is stuff that's talking about in the end of days, what is coming. You know, just maybe if you know about it now, you won't be tricked into taking a mark of the devil or worshiping this false beast guy who claims to be God or claims to be a Messiah or something. Okay? I don't know if anybody's going to see this that will be in that position, but it's good to know that it's there in the Bible. And a lot of people don't read these things, so they wouldn't know it. But the Old Testament talks about it in the prophet Isaiah, and then also in the book of Revelation, the last book of the entire Bible, talks about a lot more detail, like I just read. So, you know, just something to think about, take it to heart, ignore it and move on, you know. But anyway, I just wanted to share that, and I've got something else in mind that I might share next, but we'll see. For now, we'll just say Yehovah bless you and keep you. Shalom.